I'm looking at the Irish Times again. Stanislavski passes by Deirdre O'Connell late at the Actor Studio in New York. I had already bought The Actor Prepares, but I couldn't follow it, I couldn't understand. Jesus, I said, this is it. I better get down and get it, at least interviewed for this. So down I went to a place called the Pocket Theatre in Ely Place. It had a stage about that size, a small stage. And sitting inside in the front row was this beautiful looking lady with blonde hair down to her waist, dressed all in black. She looked like a female Buddha. "Well, Thomas," very soft voice, "well, Thomas, have you done any acting before?" "Yes, yes, Mr. Carter." "Well, where was that?" "It was the Nice Table Tennis." "Now, Thomas, I want you to get up on the little stage. And I want you to see in front of you the most beautiful sunset you've ever seen. Then I want you to walk to the middle, and I want you to see the room you were born in. Then you walk to stage right, and you see your dog being killed by a bus." So, right, down, walk down. Down. "Go ahead, Thomas. That's good." "Very good." "Excellent." "Excellent." "Now, Thomas, thank you very much. May ring you tomorrow." So you said one of the stairs, not spoken like Anyway, believe it or not, the phone rang the next day, and I was in. And I didn't understand what went on there for years. But I said to Deirdre, after about 5 or 6 years I was in, I said, "Deirdre, how did I get in here? I mean, why did you take me?" "So I knew what you were doing," she said. "The idea was, I didn't know how to do it. And the truth. But I wasn't phony. That was the key to it. And that's why I did it. And if I can't do this, I'll just do this." Anyway, I got it and was in. And changed my life. Stanislavski changed my life. Deirdre was had her own genius. And it was, that was 63. And it wasn't heard of to have workshops or tuition. Brendan Smith Academy was there. I remember that. But this was different. This, I bought Stanislavski's at The Actor Prepares, and I couldn't understand what he was on about. So I even got a copybook one day, and I copied the whole book into the copybook to see who to speak to. Not likely. Anyway, I started gradually, and cut a long story short, one day, maybe after a year and a few months, I was doing some improvisation up on the stage. And something just clicked, or not a click, not literally a click, something went up and said, "I can do this." So it was the first real insight that I said, "I'm going to stick at this," because my feeling anyway was that if I didn't do it, in some way I'd go mad. Copying a whole book into a copy. Have a look at that for a start.